The BV-155. Iconically large radiators, large propeller blades, and high aspect ratio wings make this beauty suited for extremely high altitude flight. Never saw active service, but some test flights were done. We'll see how it performs in War Thunder, how it fights, and talk about why the aforementioned features help it fly so high. For a high altitude interceptor, it climbs dissappointingly slow. Supposed to operate above 50,000 feet, we'll only take her to 20,000 feet because this is a live match, and even that is too high for this BR. If you want to see it go higher, I've gone above the max in real life altitude with it in a much older video, which I'll link in the end. Now, the need for those large radiators are obviously for cooling the engine oil. Aside from being bullet magnets in War Thunder, they cool the engine oil well even when the air is very thin. The prop blades are so thick and scoopy for the same reason, to operate in low density air. Now, the most interesting feature which led it to fly well at extreme altitudes is also why this baby turns extremely well. The aspect ratio of the wings. Now, there's a formula to calculate it, but at a glance you can already tell this aircraft has a high aspect ratio, which means the wings are very narrow and stick out far. As opposed to an aircraft like the Mirage 3, which suffers from the infamous delta disease, named after its delta wings and energy bleeding in turns, which actually comes from the low aspect ratio that inherently comes with delta wings. So why is this good for high altitudes and sustained turning? Simply put, efficiency. We need lift to fly. In order to achieve this, we need a positive angle of attack over the wing. The higher we go, the higher angle of attack we need to maintain flight at a given speed. The so-called lift coefficient goes up with the increased angle of attack. In the lift formula here you can see it. Altitude goes up, air density goes down, as displayed by the lowercase Greek letter rho, circled in red on the left. The larger angle of attack is what gives us this higher lift coefficient, shown by CL. Now, the problem with this is a particular type of drag, called induced drag, increases as the lift coefficient increases, like we see here. It is in fact increasing exponentially. The reason it increases is tip vortexes generated by spanwise flow from under the wing, an area of relative overpressure, to over the wing, an area of relative underpressure. The longer and narrower the wing is, the less this spanwise flow reaches the tip to turn into vortexes. It's represented in the formula by AR. In other words, high aspect ratio wings mean less induced drag. Modern passenger jets use winglets. If they knew about that back in World War II, the BV-155 would have surely had them too. It's worth noting as well that high aspect ratio wings don't go well with transonic and supersonic speed regimes. To cut a long story short, drag at higher speeds, such as form drag and the shock waves experienced at higher Mach numbers, both favor lower aspect ratio wings for a variety of reasons that I won't get into now. Now, we've looked at why the lift coefficient needs to increase in high altitude flight. It's to compensate for the lower air density. But how does it play into turn performance? Well, in turns we go for very high angles of attack, also referred to as high alpha maneuvers, with alpha being the Greek symbol used to measure the angle of attack. Here we want more lift to keep us turning, and the same laws of aerodynamics apply that we looked at before. CL goes up, CDI follows with it exponentially. A high aspect ratio wing would simply suffer less from it. Now, this is why it turns tight and sustains it really well. Worth noting, the BV-155's roll rate is terrible, likely by the strong dihedral in the wings, only exacerbated by their length. What happens is the downgoing wing creates more lift than the upgoing wing. Being pointed inward, it kind of works even harder against the roll. It's called the dihedral effect. Great for stability, terrible for air combat. This is also why they say modern jets are made to be as unstable as possible. Okay, well, sorry about all that. This aircraft and its unique features just scream for an aerodynamics lesson. Let's look at how it performs in combat now. Okay, here we got an AI aircraft. You can see it by its wavy movement. Good test subject for our cannons. It's a good reason to pick gold maps for piston aircraft that don't have radars, because you can just see the contrails. You can even see them at lower altitudes, which make it very easy to find targets. Just checking if it's not a friendly, for sure. No IFF here. Opa, that's a nice fireball. See, it just wrecks it apart. So following what appears to be an XB-50 here, some from far out already. It's got good contrails on this map that you can follow. Not 100% sure it's an enemy, so just closing in. There's two other aircraft there. Taking some pot shots. Nah. Too used to long range engagements in top tier. Let's get closer. The problem is he climbs way better. I think it's a P-38 fly, shooting at an AI bomber of ours. Both climb better than me. I should turn better than them, so unfortunately they're higher than me, but maybe I can get one of them. Cockpit visibility is terrible too, so we'll see how this goes. Let's dive for some speed so we can keep nose authority. I'm very disadvantaged, but let's continue anyways. There he goes. Quick reversal, and he's staying vertical. That doesn't look good for us because we have terrible climb performance. We're also a big target. Like I said, radiators are bullet magnets. The airframe is made of wood. How hard to lead with this cockpit? No, completely the wrong direction. You know, I don't know who thought it's a good idea to have large, long oil lines running through a wooden airframe. Get another shot. No. Went a bit closer, but I didn't get it. See, I turn better than they do, but the whole vertical part is where they can get me easily. See, where did he go? There he is. Oh, and they got me. The XB50. Yeah, it was bound to happen. Now, as you can see, this thing has no problem turning, but yeah, avoid the confrontations where you need to go vertical. And have a quick look at the rewards. In total here, I shot an AI and captured a point in the first useful actions. The rewards are quite good. I had a kill after that, the recording didn't work. And then the last one in the end was just a death. I'd say rewards are pretty good for a BR 4.0 aircraft. And I think if you can still get this somehow, because it was like an old PP vehicle, but if you can still get it in a future event or whatever, yeah, it's a good one. It's fun to fly and it's just very unique. Let me know how you guys liked watching this video. If the aerodynamics lesson was interesting or too boring, or you want to hear more stuff like that, let me know. And as always, thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one.